Republican Senator Tommy Tuberville from the state of Alabama has been in the news a lot recently, not only for his blockade of Biden's nominations to effectively run the United States military, where the Marines are actually now without a leader for the first time in their history, and that's all thanks to Tommy Tuberville. But he was also in the news last week, of course, for defending white nationalism, saying it's just an opinion that these people are racist. He says they're just Americans. And then he defended that statement by becoming even more racist by saying that he, as a football coach, has, quote, dealt with more black people than anyone. So you would think, with his basically assault on the military, you know, his embracing of white nationalism, trying to rebrand them as something they're not, you would think that that would be costing him. But according to a new report, he's actually gaining in popularity in his home state of Alabama. Now, I guess technically that shouldn't be a surprise, right? When your senator openly embraced racism, you know, 49 other states, that's probably going to cause you a bit of a problem. But you go do that in Alabama, they're going to be like, oh, hell yeah. Let's get out the hoods. This guy's one of us. So I get it. Totally get why in the state of Alabama, embracing racists would actually elevate your campaign instead of destroying it. And that kind of seems to be the case here. But what's even worse is the fact that Tuberville's assault on the military by blocking these Biden nominations that even Republicans in the Senate want him to stop blocking. Like, they're not happy with it. They don't like it. They didn't like his racist comments last week. They denounced him. His own brother denounced him. But his constituents love it. And see, this is where I think a lot of people forget that a disconnect exists. I am probably 20 minutes away from the state of Alabama. Like, if I want to basically leave my house, I have to go to Alabama to do that. So I'm very familiar with it. I lived there for, you know, 3 or 4 years in my childhood. Moved away from Florida to Alabama, back to Florida. You know, again, we're right on the border of Alabama. I see these people. I know these people. I have lots of friends in Alabama. I do business in Alabama. And I can tell you, in a way that a lot of these other folks who do this cannot, that racism does in fact work for these folks. Blocking these, you know, Biden appointees because I'm standing up for, you know, pro-lifers is Tuberville's argument. They like that. And the problem is, when you're not close to it, when you're looking at what happens in Alabama, all the way from California, or maybe from New York, or, you know, even further up north, you're looking at it from a blue state perspective. You're looking at it and you're thinking, well, how can these people be so horrible? The whole state of Alabama, just a bunch of racists. No, trust me, they got a lot of them, but the whole state is not, in fact, racist. Yeah, you know, I will definitely say that. I think it's ridiculous to think any state is 100% racist. But there are plenty of them. And that's the problem, right? You don't have that perspective. Most of these folks who do what I do, they've never even gone to Alabama. They've never driven through. They've never spent time there. They've never gone to school there. So it's not surprising that you have people like Tuberville who feel totally confident making these statements. They feel totally confident blocking military appointments because they know that back home it's not going to hurt them. If Tommy Tuberville sees his approval rating drop in New York or California, that means nothing. Like, people attacking him from West Coast and East Coast, so that doesn't do anything to him because back in his home state, he is loved. And the reason I'm saying that, the reason I'm trying to give that perspective, is because it tells us a lot about why these elected officials, not just Tuberville, do what they do. Just because we don't like it doesn't mean it doesn't play well in their state. I honest to God, Joe Manchin is a great example of that. Up until a few months ago, Joe Manchin had the fifth highest approval rating for a senator from their own state. Because as much as we hate his obstruction, as much as we hate his anti-environmentalism stances, his constituents loved it. And that's why he did what he did and does what he does to this day. And it's the same thing with Tuberville. Y'all may think it's gross and disgusting, and it is. I hate him for it. I hate him for a lot of other reasons. I am an Auburn football fan. Hate him for that. But until you get to know these people on the ground, you can't fully understand why he does it. They love it. And that's what this new report is trying to tell us. Tuberville's not going to stop. He's not going to be less racist. He's not going to be less obstructionist because it's actually helping his poll numbers. It's helping his, you know, next election campaign. And if you're not close to it, then it's easy to see why you don't get it. The way those of us who see that racism every day, we understand it. And this isn't surprising to us at all.
Thanks for watching, everyone, and well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.